Hi guys, this is David from Twomey Strength Conditioning. So today what I'm going to be going over is the deadlift. So I'm going to be breaking it down because the deadlift is one of the best exercises in the world and it can be one of the worst exercises in the world. Because think of it, there's so much muscle recruitment actually being used and muscle activation. So using the likes of the quads, the hamstrings, adductors, abductors, the glutes, the erector spinae, mid traps, rhomboids, teres major, posterior delts, you're getting abdominal contraction using your upper traps. You're using so many muscles at one time. So here we have Veronica today. So she's going to be the participant for this. So what she's going to do now, we're just showing the setup position. So a lot of people get this wrong. They reckon it's like a squat, but it's not like a squat. What you need to do is walk into the bed, leg shoulder width apart. Think of it, if your legs weren't together and you got pushed, you're gonna fall flat on your ass. And don't lie, people will laugh. So what you want to do is make sure that your legs are shoulder width apart, okay? So then you're getting your stabilized muscle into it, your adductors, abductors. You want to pull yourself down, make sure you get tension on the quads and the hamstrings. Squeezing the upper back together, keep the chest up. Make sure it's not closed. So you want to make sure everything's tight so there's no kinks in the armor. Everything has to be tight. You never put weight onto a length of muscle. So pull yourself down into it. So you get the anterior chain and posterior chain into it. Okay? So next what we're going to do, we're going to look at hip drive. A lot of people laugh at me when I talk about hip drive because like the easiest way to explain it is it's like a jiggy or a sex and stuff like that. I know it sounds funny, but what you need to do, yeah, think of it, if you have strong hips, you're going to have a strong squat and deadlift, so you're going to get your glutes into it, adductors, abductors. So what you need to do is pull yourself down and then drive the hips forward. So see that? That was very relaxed. You're going to see it's going to get more aggressive, so you need to be fast with this. So see the way it's coming up a little bit faster than it was previously. So you're going to pull yourself down and watch this is a bit more aggressive, so it's a lot faster. So what Veronica's doing there is she's squeezing the glutes and she's pushing the hips forward. So each time, pull down, make sure that she gets tension in the quads, the hamstrings, squeezing the upper back together, keep the chest up, nice, excellent. So now what we're going to look at is bracing. So when you think of bracing, yeah, think of it, the easiest way to explain bracing's breathing. If you've got a Coke can, you took the cap off it, yeah, and then was called there's no Coke in it, and you put pressure on it, that Coke can is going to get compressed, it's going to crush, okay? So if you get a Coke can, and it's filled with Coke, you try to compress it and stuff, it's going to be harder to break, isn't it? Same with the body, you need to make sure that you create tightness. So a great way to actually explain bracing is to try and get as much oxygen into the body as physically possible. So what you need to do is pull yourself down, you're going to get a nice deep breath, make sure it gets into that thoracic cage so you get it into the chest, the lungs, the stomach, everything. So you're trying to, just visualization. So what we're going to do is you're going to pretend that you're on a different planet, a survival of the fittest. You're going to be a greedy fucker, so you're going to try and get as much oxygen into the body as possible. Even think of it, you're like Henry the Hoover, so something funny like that. So you pull yourself down, you make sure you get that breath. So once it gets into the chest, the lungs, you feel it there, you hold the breath, and you exhale once it gets past the knees. So you need to make sure that everything's tight, because once something's relaxed and it's not tight, that's where there's a kink in the armor, you're going to hurt yourself. So you need to make sure everything is tight. So now you can see, Veronica pulls herself down, squeezes the upper back, chest up, tension in the quads and hamstrings, gets a nice deep breath before she goes up, makes sure that she's set up, gets the breath, holds the breath, exhales past the knees. So like, the deadlift is very complicated, like, so you need to just break it down and put it in step by step. So now we're going to be picking a point on the floor, so to keep the body in a good neutral position. So now, and another thing that we're going to do is come down fast. Think about, what's gravity trying to do? Gravity is trying to bring the weight down. So what we're going to do is, we're not going to look at the eccentric phase of the exercise. So when I say eccentric phase, it's the down phase of the actual exercise. So we're just looking at the concentric phase where the muscle actually flexes. So this, therefore, we're going to save energy then as well. So you see the way she came down fairly quick, so she's conserving her energy each time. She's not smashing the weight off the ground, she's just coming down quick with it. Rather than bringing it up to the top and letting go of it, like you see in CrossFit and stuff like that, we're not doing that because you have to finish the actual lift. So if you're a powerlifter and stuff, we all know that you have to come up to the top, which is the lockout position, and you need to come down with it as well. So now you pull yourself down, tension in the quads, hamstrings, squeeze shoulder blades together, chest up, nice deep breath, exhale on the way up, and then come down quick with it, picking that point on the floor. Okay, now we're going to use a bell, okay? So if you think that you want to get the best abdominal contraction that you can physically possible. So when you put a belt on you, think of your stomach. Your stomach's going to get smaller because it's pushing your stomach in. So you're not going to get as much air into it. So what we have to do now is we make sure that the chest is over the bed. So we get a nice deep breath when the chest is over the bed. We drop the hips down, sink the hips into it, and then we exhale once it gets past the knees. So think of it, if you get a Coke can and you start compressing it, there's not going to be as much coke that will be able to fit into it, okay? So then what we want to do is make sure, like, think of it. You see people that have abs and all that when they stand and all that. If you see them sitting down, they're going to have this little butter belly going on and stuff, yeah? So it's the same in this. So we're going to try and get as much air into the body, get that little butter belly, pull yourself down, and exhale. So then you're pushing your abs against the actual belt. You get that abdominal contraction. Thank you very much, lads. So if you're interested in personal training, there's my business card as so. Please don't be afraid to give me a text, call, email, whatever. Thanks. See you then.